Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of death. Gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom. Teach us love. You were chosen by the Father. You were chosen for the Son. You were chosen from all women. Gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright. Gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom. Teach us
good afternoon. Welcome to our Mass tonight. We gather to celebrate the solemnity of the Blessed Virgin Mary as the Mother of God. We also celebrate this intense giving to God for getting us to this point, and we hope that as we enter the new year, God will continue to bless us and to strengthen us all as we deal with our current health challenges. We join those who are watching online too and ask God to bless you as you join us in worship. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Dear friends, to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You forgive sinners. Christ, have mercy. You give us yourself to heal us and to bring us strength. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who through the fruitful virginity of Blessed Mary bestowed on the human race the grace of eternal salvation, grant, we pray, that we may experience the intercession of her through whom we were found worthy to receive the author of life. Our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Numbers. Speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them, this is how you shall bless the Israelites. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. So shall they invoke my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them. The word of the Lord.
Among all nations, shine your salvation. May God bless us in his mercy. May the nations be glad and exult, because you are
a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to ransom those under the law, so that we might receive adoption as sons. As proof that you are sons, God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a son, and if a son, then also an heir, through God, the word of the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The shepherds went in haste to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. When 8 days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord. So, dear friends, we gather in prayer, in thanksgiving to God, and in praise to him as we celebrate the vigil of the solemnity of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God. And we also celebrate the World Day of Peace. Besides the infant narrative, not a lot is said about Mary in the scriptures. In Islam, 2 chapters of the Quran are devoted to Mary. And in Islam, she is referred to as Maryam, mother of Isa. She's also referred to as Our Lady. And there is the Arabic word Kinita, which is also used to refer to Mary. And the word means submission to God, constant submission to God. And there is also the other word in Arabic, also used to refer to her as Tahira, one who has been purified, one not touched by Satan at any point. And you have this whole chapter devoted to our Blessed Mother in the Quran. Scripture scholars tell us that Luke mentions Mary the most, 12 times in his Gospel. And the Gospel of Matthew mentions Mary 5 times. And Mark mentions her only once. And John, in his own writing, the Gospel of John, refers to Mary twice, but without using her name. And by inference and conclusion, we know that, yes, she was referring to Mary, the mother of Jesus. For us, what is the implication? The implication of the feast that we celebrate today is the fact that God has become one of us through the instrumentality of the one he has chosen, the Blessed Mother. And by that honor and grace, she became the Mother of God. It's a mystery, and I'm not sure that we can adequately explain it, but through the incarnation and the birth of Jesus, Mary became one of us. And if you like, God reaffirming what he already did in the book of Genesis. For God said in Genesis, let us make man and woman in our own image. So male and female, he created them. And so we share the very life of God. We share in the very mystery of God. And when we turn to our first reading, the priestly prayer of Aaron, a very, very beautiful prayer, speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them, this is how you shall bless the Israelites. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And thirdly, the Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. So shall they invoke my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them. I invite each and every one of us, my dear friends, to personalize this blessing, because it is a very beautiful prayer. In all three verses, the first part refers to an activity on the part of God. Bless, make his face shine, and turn his face towards us. And the second part describes the effect of the blessing on us. God giving us his protection, giving us his grace, reaffirming his love for us as a community as well as an individual. That God, in these words, loves us not only collectively, but also individually. And by so doing, loves you and I uniquely. Uniquely for the gift that he made us to be. Uniquely for the way he shaped us. Uniquely for the way he invites us to join in sharing his divine life. The first part of that blessing, we are told in a sense, refers to material blessing. And the second part refers to a form of moral blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And the third part, that God through the words, like a father looking out for his own son or daughter in the crowd. You know, imagine you trying to identify your son at a baseball game or at a football game in the crowd. And what do? You are setting your eyes like a telescope, looking around to see where John or Agnes is seated. And when you see, what do? You wave. And maybe he or she recognizes you and then waves back. And then you run towards each other. And so by this blessing, by the third blessing, God searches for us uniquely, in a unique way, in the beautiful way that he has crafted you and I, yet very different. He has blessed us very differently. He has assigned us something very differently. And so today, my dear brothers and sisters, as we journey into the new year and as we celebrate Mary as the mother of God, that God elevated one of us in Christ Jesus to be his own mom. By that, he continues to elevate us and invites us to live a life deserving of that dignity, to live a life deserving of that honor that he has conferred on you and I. And so as we move into the new year, this outgoing year has been tough for every single one. And I invite us to remember and to find comfort in what we celebrate today, that God loves you uniquely, that God loves me uniquely. No matter what people may think about me, that weighs me down, that makes me feel bad about myself, that makes me have a low self-esteem of myself, that makes me feel not being proud of myself, I invite you to remember that you are unique, and there is no other John or Paul or Agnes or Cecilia
anywhere on this planet beside you, seated here right now or watching at home in Canton. And therefore you are special. We are special. And because of that, the Lord blesses you in the walls of Aaron and invites you to be in the coming year a conduit of that same blessing to those you encounter, to those I encounter, to bless your children in these walls of Aaron, to bless your friends in these walls of Aaron, to bless all those you encounter in these walls of Aaron. And by so doing, each and every one of us will do what? We send the devil running. But we need to believe it. We need to hold it. So as we leave here tonight, my dear friends, let us memorize this blessing of Aaron and bless each other by morning, by afternoon, and by night. Very simple. Say, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with look upon you kindly and give you peace. May God hear our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. Dear friends, may we now arise with the faith and trust modeled by Mary, the Mother of God. Let us offer our prayers to God this day.
For the Holy Father, may God bless him with a year of good health as he leads the church in wisdom and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For public authorities, may the Lord strengthen them in integrity and courage for leadership that safeguards all human life from conception to natural death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For peace in our world, especially in places where there are ongoing conflict, that leaders will see the sufferings of their people and so reach a settlement. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who lack hope, may the promise of the Lord's faithfulness bring them consolation and joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our faith community, may Christ, who came in flesh to save us, be born anew in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have died in faith, may they soon rejoice in God's presence, glorifying and praising him for all eternity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. Let us now add our own private intentions. Lord, hear our prayers as we all say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Heavenly Father, in your wisdom, please hear and answer our prayers this day, spoken and unspoken, through your Son, Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
Yeah.
pray, my dear friends, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Amen. O God, who in your kindness begin all good things and bring them to fulfillment, grant to us who find joy in the solemnity of the Holy Mother of God, that just as we glory in the beginnings of your grace, so one day we may rejoice in its completion. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the solemnity of the motherhood of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal life, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him, the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven, and the blessed seraphim, worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take these, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more, giving thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take these, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Song, let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession we rely for help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Sean our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of these family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. By divine teaching, we continue to pray as we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you say to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Have mercy Dear friends, behold the Lamb of God. Behold Jesus Christ, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are invited to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to eternal life. Amen. Holy Communion, we shall begin on this side, so I'll be on this side and you will be here. So those of you at the extreme left, you remain seated, and then those of you here, you remain seated also. When we are done, then you can follow. Thank you.
Infant Holy, oxen blowing, little knowing, Christ the babe is Lord of all. Swift are winging, angels singing, nobles ringing, tidings bringing, Christ the babe. Flocks were sleeping, shepherds keeping, vigil till the morning dew. Saw the glory, heard the story, tidings of the gospel true. Thus rejoicing, free from sorrow, praises voicing, greet the morrow. Christ the babe was born for you. Christ the babe was born for you.
I invite you to pray with me. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Jesus, I love you. All I have is yours. Yours I am and yours I want to be. Do with me whatever you will. Amen. Let us pray. We have received this heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that it may lead us to eternal life, for we rejoice to proclaim the blessed ever Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son and Mother of the Church. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the God of infinite goodness, who by the incarnation of his Son has driven darkness from the world, and by that glorious birth has illumined this day, drive far from you the darkness of vice, and illumine your hearts with the light of virtue. Amen. May God, who willed that the great joy of his Son's saving birth be announced to shepherds by the angel, fill your minds with the gladness he gives, and make you heralds of his gospel. Amen. And may God, who by the incarnation brought together the earthly and heavenly realm, fill you with the gift of his peace and favor, and make you sharers with the church in heaven. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you now and forever. Amen. Thank you for joining us tonight, and a very, very happy new year to you. May God grant us strength and grant us health in the coming year. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Let us go to love and to serve one another. Thanks be to God.
Good Christian friends, rejoice with heart and soul and voice. Give heed to what we say. Jesus Christ is born today. Flocks and does before him bow, and he is in the manger now. Christ is born today.